like a whole nother circumstance where he came from such a prominent, wealthy family who was a very, very well known in the community. So Mark comes up with this story that he got in a car accident on his mission and he was hurt. School. Mattress. Receipt for a Joe's opinion, this was his last ditch effort to try and, like, maybe get out of any trouble. Maybe he's laying the foundation for an insanity defense if he gets arrested. At the very least, he is now on a psychiatric hold and he cannot be questioned by police at this point. Police begin digging into anything and everything Mark has touched in his life, and they soon discover he was not accepted to medical school. He did not graduate college in the first place with his undergrad, and the list of Mark's lies is just stacking up against him. That day, his father told reporters that the family had just found out that Mark had, in fact, lied about graduating with honors, with a degree in psychology, I believe, from the University of Utah. So as the family was finding out right along with the police all of the things that Mark had been lying about, without a body, it is difficult for police to prove anything, but Mark is definitely their number one suspect in Lori's disappearance. And the problem was, police had no idea what Mark did with Lori's body. So Mark is in this mental institute on a hold, and his brothers go there to visit them. And they start pressuring him into telling them what happened with Lori. And they leave and they say, "We're going to give you the day to think about it. And when we come back tonight, we want to know what happened." So the brothers go back that night, and Mark confesses to murdering Lori. He tells his brothers he shot her in the head while she was sleeping in bed, and then he took her body and dumped it in the dumpster outside of the University of Utah psychiatric facility. He then took the mattress and dumped it at the church building, and he also took the gun and dumped it in a different location. So on August 2nd, Mark is transferred from the psychiatric facility to the Salt Lake County Jail, and he is charged with first-degree murder and 3 counts of obstruction of justice. His bail is originally set at $500,000, but later raised to $1 million. Police had been searching for Lori's body, but now that Mark had confessed, they had a location. Kind of. They knew that her body would be in a landfill, but the landfill, like, hundreds and hundreds of garbage trucks come and dump garbage, and it's, like, compacted garbage. And there's literally mountains and mountains of garbage, so they had, like, kind of an idea of what area she may have been dumped in. And so volunteers, police officers, began sifting through the landfill. Now it's August, it is hot, it's smelly, there's bugs. They tried to bring in cadaver dogs, but there were so many conflicting scents that they couldn't really help. So people were just sifting through the garbage. They estimated it could take up to 30 days to find Lori's body, and it actually took longer than that. A police officer opened a garbage bag that he had found in the landfill, and hair came out of it, along with a jawbone. So at that point, they, like, stopped all much of Lori's remains as they possibly could. Now, because of the heat and the time that had passed, and the fact that the trash had been compressed, they didn't find all of Lori's remains. Lori weighed about 110 pounds. They found about 35 pounds worth of her remains. They searched to try to find every single fragment they could to A, give to Lori's family so they could bury her and have closure, and then also they wanted it all for evidence. Now, because of found, they were unable to charge Mark with manslaughter of the unborn baby because they just were not able to prove that she was ever pregnant due to the decomposure. Police never did find the rifle that Mark used to kill Lori. During his first arraignment, he actually pled not guilty, which is weird because he had already confessed to the murder. In April 2005, Mark pled guilty to murdering his wife, and the state dropped the obstruction of justice charges against him. He was sentenced 6 years to life for this crime. A hunting rifle to kill her, that added a year. But that is not very long for killing someone. The thought that they could be out in 5 years or 6 years is kind of crazy. Mark is up for parole in 2035. Lori's parents removed hacking from her headstone, so they just dropped her married name. Started a college scholarship fund in her name, and actually Oprah donated a substantial amount of money to the fund. Mark has twice been caught trying to sell memorabilia from the murder on a murder website. I don't know what he was trying to sell, but that he was caught twice, and that has been stopped twice. On March 20th, 2005, House 102 passed a bill that is called Lori's Law, which makes the minimum sentence of murder 15 years instead of the 5 that it was previously. So that is the story of the murder of Lori. I was so hesitant to talk about this is because Dr. Hacking, Mark's father, I knew him personally. He was a phenomenal person. He is a doctor. I was a nurse, and I actually worked at one of the hospitals that he would round at. So I knew him professionally. My children did not go to him as a pediatrician, only because we lived like pretty far away from his practice. But he did see several of my children during like after hours when our office was closed. And when my baby boy was born, he was born, it was an emergency C-section, and I was at a hospital that was not equipped to deal with that, and so the hospital called the nearest pediatric office, which was his, and said, "Hey, we're about to deliver a baby, and we don't know if this baby is gonna live. Is there a pediatrician who could come over here right now and help?" And so Dr. Hacking was life lighted